Very good morning to all. Looking at important headlines from the Hindu newspaper for 1st March. On the front page you have, Pakistan will release Abhinandan today. So this is Indian Air Force pilot, Wing Commander Abhinandan Vardhman. We saw in news yesterday how he entered into, crossed the LOC into Pakistan occupied Kashmir and is now in custody of Pakistan. So as a peace gesture, Prime Minister of Pakistan Imran Khan has said that he would be released today. He also said that he tried to contact Prime Minister Narendra Modi, but India's stand is that no talks will take place till Pakistan takes action on terror outfits. So, then this is Trump-Kim talks collapse. So, this will be covered in detail on the foreign international page too. So, the US President Donald Trump and North Korean leader Kim Jong-un, they had a summit held in Hanoi, Vietnam, but the talks collapsed. And this is Supreme Court stays eviction of tribals, forest dwellers. So we have been seeing regarding this the last few days, the Supreme Court had called for eviction of all those tribals, forest dwellers whose rights were not approved or, you know, accepted under the Forest Rights Act, the entire rules and the legal procedure which is there in place. So if their rights have been rejected, they should be evicted. And Supreme Court was putting pressure and was asking the states to take action. No action has been taken so far. So central government has given its, has put its papers in before the Supreme Court, saying that the tribals and forest dwellers who are staying here traditionally, though their rights have not been, accepted, but still the entire legal process has not been followed. The legal process has to be, followed, and the Gram Sabhas also, they are not well equipped to understand how to accept that, how to judge on the rights of tribals and forest dwellers. So that is why it has asked the Supreme Court to stay the order. And Supreme Court today, the news is, it has stayed its own order of eviction of tribals and forest dwellers. On page 6, you have laborers soar over wait for wages under rural job scheme. So this is regarding Mahatma Gandhi National Rural Employment Guarantee Act. Though there is NREGA Sangharsh Morcha, which has filed a complaint against main accused, that is Centre. It says the government seems to have plenty of money to fund bullet trains, but not for wages of labourers. Then on page 7, you have AJL told to move out of Herald House. So this is Associated Journals Limited, which is publisher of National Herald newspaper. So this belongs to Congress, rather to the Gandhi family. So the newspaper as such, the publishers have been told to move out of Herald House. They challenged the central government's order of eviction in Delhi High Court, but Delhi High Court has dismissed the petition. So it says the bench also questioned the acquisition of AIL by the Young India. So it says that this was take over the right to recover a loan of more than 90 crore, and also it has interest in the premises basically. So that is why central government order came and Delhi High Court has upheld that order. That this is cabinet clears voluntary use of Aadhaar as identity proof. So we have seen the Supreme Court order where it has upheld the Aadhaar but allowed it to be used mandatorily for some purposes, like for social welfare schemes, but not for admission to educational institutions or for opening a bank account. But then there was a question, can Aadhaar voluntarily be used as an identity proof? It cannot be mandatory. So there was no clarity in the Supreme Court order. So government has now cleared this proposal for amendment. So it will approve the promulgation of this ordinance to allow voluntary submission of Aadhaar as identity proof for use by private entities like banks, telecom companies, financial, fintech companies, etc. On the editorial page, the first editorial is coming home. So this is regarding the release of Indian Air Force pilot, which we saw on the front page, Abhinandan Vardhman, who has been released by Pakistan now. So the editorial says this gives India and Pakistan a chance to de-escalate tensions. And then below you have the deal maker. So this is regarding the Iranian foreign minister who has recently, resulted in a tussle between the foreign minister. He has posted his resignation on Instagram, and he has tussled with the president Hassan Rouhani of Iran. So this actually is an ideological tussle. So this is regarding that. Then the lead article is Living on the Edge. So this is regarding India, Pakistan, how there's a need to de-escalate tensions. So this is the important issue. It says India and Pakistan need to find a way to keep de-escalating tensions without either losing face. And this is regarding Nigeria's difficult democratic journey. So there has been abrupt postponement of elections, general elections. There has been chaos at polling stations, violence. So this has been the lowest ever general election turnout in Nigeria too. That is discussed, but then again, it may not be very much relevant, but at least you should know about the situation in Nigeria. Then on the op-ed page on Fridays, you have a question with yes, no, it's complicated coverage. So today the question is political, so it may not be relevant. Will Priyanka Gandhi change the fortunes of the Congress? So this may not be important for the exam at all. Then on page 10, here you have J&K ordinance cleared by Union Cabinet doesn't tinker with 35A or 370. So this is the Jammu and Kashmir Reservation Amendment Ordinance 2019 that has been approved by the Union Cabinet. So it says this is not going to tinker with the status of Jammu and Kashmir, special status under Article 370 or under Article 35A. It is to extend reservation in jobs and promotion and in education. So it extends reservation to people living 10 km from the international border in Jammu. Earlier, the benefits were only for people living 10 kilometers beyond the LOC and were affected by shelling and firing from across the border. So this is the amendment. On page 11, you have India gives Pakistan a dossier on Jaish. So this dossier by India carries specific details of Jaish-e-Mohammed's complicity in Pulwama attack and its continued recruitment drives. And this is another push at UNSC to ban Assad. So US, UK, France have moved quickly amid concerns over escalation of India-Pakistan tensions, and they are pushing to ban Maulana Masood Azhar at UN Security Council, the 1267 Sanctions Committee. On international page, you have Trump Kim failed to reach deal in Hanoi. So this was a front page news too. So the two leaders have not come to with a deal. North Korea wanted the sanctions lifted on the in the entirety, but US President says that we couldn't do that. And this is UN probe accused Israel of crimes against humanity. It calls Gaza's protests in 2018 peaceful and Israel's use of force unjustified. Then on business page you have government cuts financial year 2019 growth estimates to 7%. So third quarter growth estimates at 6 quarter low. So for this present financial year, the third quarter growth estimate has come now. It's low, and agriculture, manufacturing are said to be contributing to the slowdown. And for the overall year, government has now cut the growth estimate down to 7% from 7.2%. Then below you have Cabinet OKs National Mineral Policy 2019. So this is a policy for the mineral sector which aims to bring in more transparency, regulation and enforcement. So key features of this policy are right of first refusal for the reconnaissance permit. So the permit which is granted, so first refusal right is provided, prospecting the license holders, encouraging private sector to take up exploration and auctioning of virgin areas, new areas on a revenue sharing basis. Then next is Union Cabinet approved software product policy. So this is now National Policy on Software Products for 2019, which aims to help the industry grow at a rate of 40% to reach $70 to $80 billion by 2025. It will also create employment opportunities for around 3.5 million people. So this is regarding that. Then on the last page you have Rhinos Without Borders is conservation credo. So Asian wildlife protection experts place emphasis on expanding the species domain to boost population. So then there should be no borders for rhinos. So these are the important headlines. Thank you.